Introducing McDonald's new $1-$2-$3 menu with favorites for $1, $2, or $3, like the McChicken, the Bacon McDouble, the Happy Meal, and...
A weekend getaway with the husband and kids?
No. But the $1-$2-$3 menu could help you save for one.
Especially if we leave the kids at home.
With Grandma, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Build whatever meal you want with favorites on McDonald's new $1-$2-$3 menu. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
Welcome to Blog Talk Radio in high fidelity.
It's a new morning, it's a new day, because you live and breathe in me. It's a new dawning, brand new mercy. Yesterday's gone, so glad I can say. Sing it with me, say. It's a new morning, it's a new day, because you live.
Good morning, and thank you for joining me for Modern Living with Dr. Angela. I'm your host, Dr. Angela Chester, Blue Troop Web, Print, and Video with Lorne Thomas. That's right. That's my guest today. Small businesses rise and fall daily, while people pour incredible amounts of their time and effort into making them work. It's important to get it right. So for over 25 years, Blue Troop Web, Print, and Video has been dedicating to helping small business owners acquire the best in marketing tools for their business. So as I said, today I'm going to pick the brain of Lorne Thomas. I have all of his contact information here in the description, and it doesn't matter if you're listening on an enhanced version or not, it is there for you to see. Website, phone number, email, and Facebook. And of course, we know Facebook.com, Blue Troop Web, Print, Video. Our break today is brought to you by Vital Credit Card, the credit card that pays you to share. And we have a musical selection today by Blood on Our Hands by the Reverend Peter Unger. So without any further ado, let's get Lorne on the line. Hello, good morning. Thank you so much for sharing with us today.
Hey, Dr. Angela, how are you doing?
I am well. I'm so glad that you're able to come in and speak to our listeners today.
Yeah, glad to be here.
Now, I love that you are helping businesses. As an entrepreneur myself, any bit of advice, any golden nuggets, as I say, you're always trying to gather them along the way to make sure that you're doing what you're supposed to do. So before we get started, I know that people want to know a little bit about your background and what made you decide to start your business.
Sure, you bet. I've been in the Dallas-Fort Worth market area doing advertising and marketing now for about 28 years, and I've worked everything from small ad agencies to the large corporate environments, doing much in the way of graphic support. I've had my hand in many different aspects of advertising and marketing, video, print, and now about 15 years ago began with internet marketing and websites. So, I'm working with large and small customers, kind of run the gamut and see, you know, how best to connect with those target audiences. And everybody's different. Mm-hmm. It depends on who you're trying to reach and the mm-hmm. scale of your business. But yeah, I've really enjoyed it. And I like sharing knowledge about how to best accomplish that.
Right. Now, there may be someone who's asking the question of, I'm thinking of having an internet-only based business, or more so internet-based than having like a traditional or office or storefront-based business. Would you say that there is a difference in how they should go about their marketing, or how they want to create more buzz about their business, determining the different style of business that they have?
Sure. The best part of that is if you want to have a brick-and-mortar business versus a virtual business, internet business, mm-hmm. is that the web, the internet is a great equalizer. So your audience doesn't know whether or not you have a large presence, brick and mortar location versus a virtual business. So that's the best part of all. So you can now compete with the big guys. The little guys can now compete with the big guys, depending on their marketing, how they set up their presentation, their presence. But again, reaching that audience is different because my customer is going to be different than your customer. So we first have to identify who we're going after, our demographic and information about them. Essentially, we profile them and find out, you know, who best would be my best customer. And then how do I go about reaching them? It might be driven through the internet. It might be driven through print and video and other ways, too. But my path to them is not going to be the same as your path because we're selling different products or services.
Right. Alrighty, listeners, we need to take a very short break, but you can definitely soak that nugget in. We are about to listen to Blood on Our Hands by the Reverend Peter Unger, and you can find him on ReverbNation.com, Rev Peter Unger. We'll be back right after this.
Gas toe on the water, watch it carried out to sea. Lord, I wonder as it drifts out of sight, will it ever come back to me? Gas care on the water, watch it carried out to sea. Lord, I wonder as it drifts out of sight, will it ever come back to me?
And we are back. Thank you so much for joining me for Modern Living with Dr. Angela. I'm your host, Dr. Angela Chester, Blue Troop Web, Print, and Video with Lorne Thomas. We are talking getting your business out there the best way possible for your business. Lorne, there are so many things that I want to ask, and I know that we are very limited in our time, but can you tell us what are some... maybe specific solutions, of course, that you can share that a small business owner might want to integrate into either their day-to-day or into their quarterly for greater success or just taking it to the next level?
Okay, sure. I'll give you a list of five, and there's many, you know, obviously there's many that we can go through, but I'll give you a good solid list of five. If someone is first starting out and thinking about starting a business on their own, now is the perfect time. The economy is great. It's very strong. If you live in a large market, there's plenty of customers out there for everyone. When I first started out doing what I do, there were customers everywhere. But remember, they don't come to you. You have to go to them and you have to find them. Once you do and you build up that client base, it starts rolling from there. You get a synergy effect and you start getting referrals and references and you start building your business from there. Nothing happens quickly. You know, if you're going to build a strong business, it happens slowly and it grows slowly. And that's what you want it to do. It's, you know, it's like weight loss. You know, if you're cutting weight, it doesn't come off quickly. Everyone knows it goes slowly. And that's how you sustain a lasting, you know, condition. And so I'll give you five to get started. If you're thinking of starting, you number one need a business plan. You need a clear mission statement, and you need to identify and define what you want to accomplish, and ask the question, why do I exist? You know, why do I want? You know, what need do I want to meet? So you have to have number one a clear cut, written down, pen to paper business plan of what you want to do. Secondly, you need a strong marketing plan. You need to find a way to connect with your customer. It's like what I talked about earlier. It's identifying who your customer is. Someone who sells clothing, for example, has a certain demographic, whether it be younger people, more fashionable, or more work environment, or whatever it is. The customer is going to be different. So you have to identify who that is and how the market communicates to them. It might be through social media, it might be through video, it might be through internet, it might be through direct mail, email campaigning. There's many different channels you can utilize to reach your target audience. And then third, you need a decent website. If you're in business now, that's not an option. You need a decent website and a good web presence. It needs to be clear, it needs to be easy to navigate, easy to get information from, and easy to connect to the provider. So you have to have that in place. Communication tools, that again ties in with your target audience. What's it going to be? Are you going to reach them with video, with blogging, with newsletters, podcasting like Dr. Angela? You never know, social media. There's many different ways, but what are the ways that you will try? And try many things. Some things fail and some things succeed. So you need to understand that failure is part of the process in getting there. And so try many different things. And then finally, you need an up-to-date database. This is for your customers and prospects. When you go out and you get paying customers, make sure their names and their information go into a database so you can stay in touch with them. And the same with prospects. You need to make sure you're keeping in touch with people. People don't decide to buy sometimes right away. I have many clients that I've stayed in touch with for, over a year, and they don't actually purchase from me, but we stay in touch, and they don't actually purchase from me. Maybe a year later, they'll have their website built or a video produced or something. So stay in touch. So those are the main things you can remember. Get lots of good information. The internet has great information. Go on to YouTube, go on to Google, find out small business information. But get involved and start and understand it's not a quick process. There's no good get-rich-quick schemes out there. Everything starts slowly and you build from there.
I like how you said that it's kind of like weight loss. You have to be consistent, you have to put the time in, you just have to be patient and watch it grow into exactly what you believe that it could grow into. That is a great point. Well, listeners, we need to take our very last break of the day, and then when we come back, we are going to continue to speak with Lorne Thomas of Blue Troop Web Print and Video. We'll be back right after this. How does Vital work? Vital Credit Card is the credit card that pays you to share. Get paid cash forever for each person that you sign up. Yes, that's right, 1% cash back so you can earn rewards. Share Vital Card. Share your Vital Card rewards based on how many friends you sign up. You also get credit for everyone your friends bring in and their friends too. Grow your Vital Score. Your Vital Score determines how much cash you earn each month. The more you share, the higher your score grows. Earn cash rewards. Your cash rewards are deposited straight into your account every month. Even if you have no additional shares that month, the rewards keep coming. So that's right, we want you to visit the card that pays you to share. If you're listening to this on Modern Living with Dr. Angela, then please be sure to check out the description box. Your link is right there. vitalcard.com/U/03D1B3. We want to make sure that you're signed up properly. That's right. Vital Credit Card, the card that pays you to share. We thank you for visiting each one of our sponsors for this particular show, Vital Card, as well as Reverend Peter Unger. But our guest today is Lorne Thomas, and he is giving us such great information about how to make sure that our business is moving the best way that it possibly can. Now, Lorne, I know that there may be some people who have come on a little bit later in the show, and I want to give you an opportunity to share all of your solutions. Tell us, where are you located on the internet?
Sure. Everyone can reach me at bluetroop.com. It's blue like the color, then TROOP.com. And there you can see as samples of what we do. There's many different websites. There's videos we produced and a lot of print material, graphic design that they can look through. And feel free to reach out to me through our contact form or through Facebook. We offer free website analysis. Take a look at your website and see how you can improve it. And free consultations, that's always free. I'm always happy to talk to people and answer their questions.
Well, Lorne, thank you so much for being on the show today and for sharing your knowledge with not only myself, but with our listeners.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Angela.
And listeners, thank you for joining us as well. And as always, may the Lord continue to shine his face upon you. May you receive his grace and mercy in all you do. Have an awesome, awesome week today. I'm sorry, have an awesome day today and have an awesome week. Until next time, everyone. Bye-bye.
Introducing McDonald's new $1, $2, $3 menu with favorites for $1, $2, or $3. Like the McChicken, the Bacon McDouble, the Happy Meal, and...
A weekend getaway with the husband and kids?
No. But the $1, $2, $3 menu could help you save for one.
Especially if we leave the kids at home.
With Grandma, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Build whatever meal you want with favorites on McDonald's new $1, $2, $3 menu. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Introducing McDonald's new $1, $2, $3 menu with favorites for $1, $2, or $3. Like the McChicken, the Bacon McDouble, the Happy Meal, and...
A weekend getaway with the husband and kids?
No. But the $1, $2, $3 menu could help you save for one.
Especially if we leave the kids at home.
With Grandma, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Build whatever meal you want with favorites on McDonald's new $1, $2, $3 menu. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.